Because he's disappeared, that's why. Ever since he left the dean's office, no one has seen hide or hair of him. Of course, we'll keep trying. You what? Okay. Yeah, fine. That was Saul. He says if we don't maintain our preeminence, he'll take back all his buildings. Very deep doo-doo.
Perfect information. But I have a great intern tonight, and then I have to pick up Reeves' science lab. forgot to give me an MBA.
An MBA? What is an MBA?
Get me up and I'll tell you.
Ooh. Are you okay?
Nothing an afternoon at the pub won't cure.
How long have you been up there?
Well, ever since I was an undergrad. You see, I'm in escrow. But now I'm free to go after my MBA.
What do you learn with an MBA?
All sorts of things. Computer programs like Lotus and WordPerfect.
And Lindo, too.
And Lindo, too. And tons of other stuff.
But what do you do with an MBA?
I'm glad you asked that. I could make the egg consumption and make some new assumptions on Morgan's
Thank you. galaxy. First officer, stock a scanning from Home of Affairs.
Captain, we've spotted a distress signal on the way.
Who are they, Mr. Wharton?
Ah, those are my Wimba-Wombas.
Oh, what makes me dance?
Not exactly. They're Wimba-Wombas. You know what makes them get an MBA for an ordinary MBA? They're students a lot like yourselves, except they never quite pass the math exam. I keep around for odd jobs. Anyway, we must move on.
The first being that I have a personality.
But
so. But whatever you do, don't fall asleep in class.
Oh, I won't.
Let's begin our discussion with the Anvil Club. Now, the Anvil is a good example of supply and demand.
Can anyone tell me why?
Yes.
Because the cost is fixed, so people take more food than they can eat?
Wrong. Your answer implies that the Anvil is supplying food. This is, of course, preposterous. Thus, the Anvil is a poor example for our study of supply and demand.
But, Professor, you just said it was a good example of supply and demand.
And so it is. A bad example.
I don't understand what's going on.
Now you're beginning to grasp the nature of this course.
The question is on the final.
Since the final will be multiple choice, we will accept only one of these answers. But since you'll have to answer only one of every two questions, you will have a 50% chance of a 50% chance of getting it right.
Thank you. factory doesn't produce anything.
Indeed, Senor Wharton, what of this highly vaunted restoration of American competitiveness?
Au contraire, mein Herr. Never fear, my dear. We provide very real advice to very real companies right here in Vance Hall. It's called the Small Business Development Center, the SBDC. I consider it crucial to let students have a chance at ruining other people's businesses before they actually go out and try it on their own. But we have no time for that now. We must move on.
Mr. Wharton!
John?
Mr. Wharton!
really in trouble now. Where could they have gone? Gee, maybe they're in here.
Welcome to Smokes. Got any ID?
Golly, no!
Okay, go on in.
Ew, another rotten geek.
You must have real world experience.
Where are all those people in suits going? Is it a funeral or something?
Not exactly. In fact, that's the most important room in the factory. Or at least the one we'll spend the most time.
Oh, you mean the pub?
No. But step this way and I'll show you.
Beautiful, down to
death, and they've got another thing coming. I've read the annual reports, I've run the numbers, I've done the mock interviews. These guys over here, they aren't keeping any secrets with this team right here. By round three, those clowns will be fighting each other to give us draw numbers. Yeah!
a commercial!
Welcome. I'm so glad to see so many of you here for our seminar on the video. This little session is here to assist you in finding the job of your dreams. As you may have heard at OCRS, we work in a fiscal week system because we feel this makes the process easier for all of you. The fiscal week begins on Wednesday and ends on the following Tuesday, except for the month of April when the fiscal week begins on Tuesday, skips Wednesday, and ends on the following Monday. Now, if you're Catholic, the week still begins on Sunday and ends on Saturday, except for the week of Easter, which begins on Ash Wednesday and ends on Good Friday. In April, all these dates will be moved up by one day to reflect the change in the fiscal week caused by daylight savings time. If you're a law student, all these dates and times need to be adjusted for the times and the date of the country or the company with whom you're going to be interviewing.
First we get them from the farm, pack them tight, and safe from harm,
Then we'll go and knock on doors to stock them in big grocery stores.
Would you put them in a box? Or would you use those little crocks?
Plastic crocks would make them seem like a yummy breakfast dream. We could have a big promotion to get our profit lines in motion. We'll advertise on MTV. We'll maximize the NPV.
What's our market definition? And how about the competition?
We'll target all the baby boomers, that great big mass of rich consumers. With their volume, we can't fail to get economies of scale. If competitors want to war on price, we'll squeeze their nuts in a great big vice.
Sam, I am. That's not so nice. But it shows you have some spice.
I'll do research, surveys, questionnaires. I'll sell green eggs at county fairs. I'll work alone or in a group. I'll bundle eggs and ham with soup. Green eggs and ham will penetrate every market, every state. None will stem the green egg tide. We'll distribute nationwide.
Sam, I am. I like your style. We may use you for a while. Even I feel quite inspired. Here's your hat. Well done. You're hired.
This is quite a joyous day. Consulting bites it anyway. Well, I think it's safe to say I blew that interview away.
I think you've been studying a little bit too hard lately, Sam. What happened in there?
My priming shouldn't make you flinch. You're acting like a stingy Grinch. That interview was such a cinch.
Oh, dear, I think you slipped an inch.
Now, pick that up.
Sam, did you get the job or not?
Oh, Kim, does Wharton hear a who? Of course I got it. How about you?
I made it to the fourth round.
They keep their questions clean. Make sure you keep your answers keen. Go easy on the Vaseline.
Gee, I hope they're not too mean. Sam, you're driving me insane. I'll never get this job with Bain.
The moral of this silly tale? If you're prepared, you cannot fail. Just be yourself to make the grade. Relax, enjoy. You've got it made. So listen to your old friend Sam. You too can sell green eggs and ham.
Yes. We are in, I got nothing to Dalton class. Do you feel that your students aren't listening to you? Do you worry that you don't look distinguished enough to make your classes think that you know what you're talking about? Well, don't worry anymore. New from Rusko, it's Russ Farmer's reverse Grecian formula. The product that turns your hair gray faster than McKinsey Ding's Harvard grads. Instant credibility, that's right. Our special formula actually gives you the gray highlights that you need to give you the appearance of experience. Listen to one of our many satisfied customers.
Hi, I'm Peter Fader. Before I started using Russ Palmer's reverse Grecian formula, none of my students believed that I had the experience needed to teach marketing research. But after only 2 weeks of using this product, I earned their love, respect, and admiration for my knowledge of this subject.
Russ Palmer's reverse Grecian formula is not available in any store. To get your 36-week supply, send $19.95. That's right, only $19.95. To Rusko, P.O. Box 1234, West Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, 19104. Don't delay. That's Rusko, P.O. Box 1234, West Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, 19104. Russell Palmer is a licensed trademark of the Wharton School.
Mr. Wharton, what's that room over there?
Oh, that one. Why don't we skip that one? It's not a very important room in the factory, and none of you's likely to enter it in the next 2 years.
But what is it?
Well, if you must know, it used to be Dean Palmer's office. But since he left, some of the students have been using it for less than preeminent purposes. It's quite exclusive, really.
Oh, can't we see just a little bit of it? It can't be that bad.
As you please, but don't say I didn't warn you. And for your own protection, I suggest you wear these.
Care how far we go, one
Shark, The Right Loves and Lusts of Russell Palmer, Dean of the Wharton School, and it's his memoirs. In 1955, I joined the Grand Rapids office of Ross and Company, accountants and advisors to free enterprise on matters relating to wills, probates, and organ donations.
Hey, trustee! You gonna go bowling with us tonight?
Why, España?
Mi amo Jack Emilio von Glockenspiel.
Hoy lugar du 20. Dar Maximus ist allmächtig bei Paris. Perestroika. Natürlich sind du nicht hier, doch hier, voilà, du sogar.
Ich bin ein Berliner. L'État, c'est moi.
Just as we thought. You don't speak French, Russian, German, or Japanese. In fact, in your application, you claim to be from Toledo. Then you don't even speak Spanish.
But I am from Toledo.
Sure, Toledo, Ohio. Didn't you give insider information to the search lady so that you'd be accepted to the lottery program? In your resume, you claim to have been an employee of IBM International in Paris.
But I was!
Isn't it actually true that the IBM you worked for was Industrial Bath and Mirror in Paris, Texas?
That's perfectly explained.
Furthermore, Mr. von Gleckenspeck, in your application to the Wharton School, you neglected to mention that your so-called Eurosven was actually Vienna sausages with spam labels shipped to Little Italy, New York.
I can explain all of this. It's all a big mistake.
Forget it. You're the big mistake. Heck, you don't belong here. You're not even lottery material. Yeah, buddy. You don't even smoke.
Here at Wharton.
What about men who conveniently forget to mention the fact that they have out-of-town girlfriends? Or how about using corporate receptions in order to reduce your grocery bill? Or students who claim to be interested in consulting and investment banking? And have you seen what the women have to do to succeed here at Wharton? Why don't you arrest all of them?
Bang!
But since Dean Palmer disappeared, no one's been giving any donations to the school. We've run out of money, so we've had to trim low-priority items.
Like teaching.
Thank you.
you, Garth. You passed all the tests. From micro and donuts to interviews and exams, you're a scratch golfer. And most importantly, you're not afraid to ask for money.
Thank you.